Hello everyone, in this video lecture we will talk about some important medicinal chemistry structures. The first structure, aspirin. How to remember the aspirin in simple way? Here A stands for acetyl and S stands for salicylic acid. What is that? Salicylic acid. So that is the acetyl salicylic acid, we call it as aspirin. The next one, the P indicates here prostaglandins. Everyone knows prostaglandins are an inflammatory mediators. What is that? Inflammatory mediators. That is what the next letter I indicates inflammatory. And R indicates release. And the last IN stands for inhibition. What is that? Inhibition. What is the mechanism of action of aspirin? Correct. It inhibits the prostaglandin inflammatory releases. Very simple. Nothing to mug up here. Based on name itself, you will come to know two things. One is IUPAC name of aspirin, that is acetyl salicylic acid. Another one is mechanism of action. What is the mechanism of action? Correct. It inhibits the prostaglandin inflammatory releases. That is the mechanism of action of aspirin. So how it inhibits the prostaglandin inflammatory releases, right? By inhibiting the enzyme name, we call it as COX. What is the COX stands for? Cyclooxygenase. So this enzyme helpful for the synthesis of prostaglandins. When we inhibit this enzyme, then there is no prostaglandin inflammatory releases. Then we can prevent the inflammation. That is the mechanism of action of aspirin. So now we'll see the how to write the aspirin structure. We know IUPAC name, that is the acetyl salicylic acid. We'll see the how to write the structure. What we have here? Acetyl group and salicylic acid. Acid means we know that is the COOH group. This is the acid. Benzene having the acid. Now what we want to write? Acetyl group we want to write. What is the acetyl group? Correct. O, CO, CH3, we call it as the acetyl group. What we call this group? Acetyl group. How? We already discussed CH3COOH is the acetic acid. From the acetic acid, if you remove the hydrogen, then what you will get? What you will get? CH3COO you will get. Correct? That is only I have written here. Acetyl. Okay? So this is the acetyl salicylic acid. The next one. The next structure. Here we will talk. That is dapsone. It is very important structure. How to remember the dapsone? Very easy. D indicates here di. D indicates the what? Di. A indicates amino. What it is? Amino. The next letter P stands for phenyl. In the phenyl, what is the first letter? P. S stands for sulfur. And here ONE is there. According to organic chemistry, one indicate is the what? we all knows one indicator is the what? Ketone. What it is? Ketone. So what is the IUPAC name? Diamino, diphenyl, sulfur, it contains the ketone. That is the IUPAC name of dapsone. Diamino. Di means 2. Di means what? 2. Here look at. 2 what groups we have here? Amino groups. What is the amino? NH4 is the ammonium. What is NH4? Ammonium. NH3 is the ammonia. NH3 is the ammonia. NH2 is amino. We also say it as amine. Amino or amine. How many amino groups we required? Correct. The 2 amino groups we required. So now I am writing the 2 amino groups. Here one amino group I have written. And here another amino group I have written. The 2 amino groups written. Now what it is there? Diphenyl. How many phenyls? 2 phenyls. This is the one phenyl. And this is the another phenyl. That is the diphenyl. And both phenyls, what it contains? What it contains? Sulfur. Both phenyls, what it contains? Sulfur. Sulfur means yes. Correct? Diamino, diphenyl, sulfur we have written. Now what is pending here? Ketone. What it is pending? Ketone. What is the ketone? RC double bond OR is the ketone. Here the ketone is carbon containing ketone. But in our drug contains the what kind of ketone? Sulfur containing ketone. That means sulfur contains the double bond O group. Clear? Now you look at diamino written, diphenyl and sulfur, it contains the ketone. Sulfur, it contains the ketone. That is IUPAC name of dapsone. What is the category of dapsone? Anti-leprotic activity. It has the anti-leprotic activity. Okay, that is the IUPAC name of dapsone. The next one, structure here we are going to talk, that is metronidazole. What is that? Metronidazole. Metronidazole. What is the metronidazole? Right? Metronidazole is? Yes? It is used for the treatment of GIT infections. How to remember the very simple way? Metronidazole structure. What we have here spelling? Metro. M-E-T-R-O. Correct? M-E-T-R-O. Next one. N-I-D-A-Z-O-L-E. N-I-D-A-Z-O-L-E. That is the nidazole. What we have? Nidazole. Now, metronidazole. M indicates methyl. E indicates ethyl. And here the TRO tro indicates nitro. And nidazole indicates imidazole. Nidazole indicates imidazole. And you can say here O. That O stands for hydroxy. You can remember like that. O stands for hydroxy. What we have now metronidazole? Methyl, ethyl, nitro, hydroxy, imidazole. That we call it as the metronidazole. Very simple. Methyl, ethyl, nitro, hydroxy. What is that? Imidazole. We call it as the metronidazole. First, let me write the imidazole. Here imidazole, we have the ol. What is the ol? Wohl means, according to heterocyclic chemistry, five-membered ring with unsaturation. Wherever the five-membered ring with unsaturation is there we will write OLE Wohl. That means, imidazole means it is the five-membered ring with unsaturation. So, this is the five-membered ring and here the unsaturation. And in the imidazole, it is contains the two nitrogens. What is that? Two nitrogen. Look at I am writing the two nitrogens. Here one nitrogen, here one nitrogen. Two nitrogens I have written. Unsaturation I have written. This is the imidazole. Rest of the things what we have to write? Methyl group. Next one, ethyl group. Next one, nitro group. And hydroxy group. Just we have to add that groups in imidazole structure. Nitro group, NO2. Methyl group, CH3. And ethyl group, CH2. And this ethyl group contains the hydroxy group, that is the OH. Now clear everyone, what is that metronidazole? Methyl, ethyl, nitro, hydroxy, imidazole. So we got the metronidazole structure. Methyl, ethyl, hydroxy, nitro, imidazole, that is the metronidazole. Use it for the treatment of GIT infections. Very simple, metronidazole. The next structure here we are going to write, that is paracetamol. Paracetamol. What is the paracetamol structure? How to remember the paracetamol structure? Look at here, what we have? Para, that is the position of benzene. This is the position of benzene. Next one, aceta. Aceta A, M. So, aceta A, M. What it indicates? It is the acetamide. Right? Acetamide. Aceta plus amide. That is the acetamide. We have written this one. Entire this one. And what it is there? Wohl. Wohl indicates alcohol. Wohl indicates alcohol. That is paracetamol, paraacetamide, alcohol. That we call it as the paracetamol. So, what is the structure of paracetamol? And how to write the structure now? We know para position means this is the benzene. Correct? This benzene contains the what? This is the para position. And this para position, acetamide group is there. What is the acetamide? Just now we discuss, this is the acetic acid. From this acetic acid, you remove the OH and add the NH2 group. Then what you will get? CH3, C double bond O, NH2 you will get. You remove the hydroxyl group and add the NH2. CH3, CO, NH2. We say it as the acetamide. What we call this one? Acetamide. So, para position we have the acetamide group. Para position what we have? We have the acetamide group. Right? First, let me write the acetamide group now. NH, C double bond O, CH3. This is the acetamide and this is the OH alcohol. Right? So, paracetamide alcohol, that is paracetamol. What is the category of paracetamol? It is an NSAID, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drug. Now, the question is, paracetamol is having the anti-inflammatory activity? Answer is no. Answer is no. Paracetamol don't have an anti-inflammatory activity. Why? What is the reason? That we will discuss in the next session. Thank you. We'll meet in the next session.